The lack of deaths in the brewery is perhaps a less salient part of Jon Snow's map, but it's certainly an interesting one. As it turns out, the brewery gave an unlimited beer allowance to its workers. And since the fermentation process killed the cholera bacteria, none of the workers contracted the disease. You can read more about the outbreak and Jon Snow's discovery in the instructor notes. His work in visualization were the start of modern epidemiology. Jon Snow demonstrated how data visualization can be used to trace the spread of disease. In this case, a single pump carrying contaminated water throughout a community. Here's a different interactive visualization that comes from The Guardian, which encodes missing values in a slightly different way. This visualization displays the extent to which gay rights are protected by law in each of the states as of May 2012. States that have no laws or that are unclear about the laws have this light gray coloring, and states that prohibit or ban gay rights have this striped pattern. For example, many states in the Northeast have employment laws which prohibit discrimination based on sexual orientation and gender. While most states in the Southeast and many in the Midwest lack such employment laws. This is an interesting visualization because it makes use of texture or pattern to represent different aspects about the states. For example, this outer red ring displays many states that prohibit or ban same-sex marriage. And this darker blue inner ring shows a few states that do not permit adoption by a single person or joint adoption by same-sex couples. Between this visualization and Jon Snow's map, we can see that there are many ways to encode values of zero, missing values, or perhaps other categorical values of data like in this visualization. So now I'd like to turn it over to you.